This might seem excessively cautious, but I think it might help given the conditions that these plants were received in. Hi everyone, my name is Gray from Grow Thickly. I think that the rare plant market has changed dramatically over the past 12 months because of a technology called tissue culture. So tissue culture is a method to duplicate plants or clone plants and create a lot of plants from just a single organism. So what you get is very high quality clones of the same plant, so everyone can have rare plants at an affordable price. So we're going to demystify how to best take care of your tissue culture plant so that you can have a thriving specimen in no time at an affordable price. So over here, we have a Monstera that we have deflushed just a week ago. You can tell that the leaves are still curling, which means that it's not adapted to the low humidity environment yet, which is why we are keeping a humidity dome over it to ensure that it has enough humidity so that it can get through the acclimatization phase. So what we're going to do is to deflush two Monstera Bulbasaur that we have over here. So if you're going to get plants of a reasonable size, I think they still cost a couple of $100s, but because we got them in tissue culture, they are less than $30 a piece. So we are very excited to be able to deflush them and grow them into the specimens that we see on other people's Instagram. So what we are going to do is we have to prepare 2 glasses of clean water, and we are going to have 70% alcohol. We are going to spray and sanitize the surfaces, the scissors, and our hands. And we are going to have some iodine. You can get this from the drugstore. I'm using it from a Q-tip, but it can come in a bottle form as well. You just need a couple of drops into your water to create a solution that is going to sanitize your plants. Then next, we are going to have the grow lid system. We're using the grow lid system as the humidity dome because we want it to grow inside a single vessel so that when it's ready, it can be potted into the grow lid system where it can have its best growth possible. So let us start by sanitizing the surfaces that we are working on. Okay, remember to sanitize your hands. Okay, just give everything a quick wipe down. You want a pair of sharp scissors, sanitize it as well. Give it a quick wipe down. So tissue culture plants are grown in a condition that is completely free from virus and other pathogens. So they are very sensitive, they have almost no immune system. You really want to take care of them to make sure that they have the best growth possible and the best start in life. So we are going to sanitize the bags as well. Okay. Now that that's done, let me sanitize the vessels that they're going to be in. Now we add the iodine drop into the 2 glasses of water. Now with a clean surface and 2 iodine glasses of water, we are ready to open the tissue culture plants. So just take a pair of sharp scissors and open up the bag. Be careful not to injure the plant. With that done, and with clean hands, we are now ready to remove the tissue culture plant. So tissue culture plants are grown in a jelly that helps to promote multiplication and division. This jelly is highly nutritious and therefore very susceptible to infection. So what we want to do is to get rid of the jelly as much as possible. So we use the first cup as the media to rinse off the jelly. Okay. You want to get rid of all the jelly as much as possible because the jelly is going to be the first thing that gets infected with fungus or bacteria or viruses. That's going to hurt the growth of your plant. I'm going to use the Q-tip to really get in between the roots as well. Okay, now that this plant is done, what we can do now is to immerse it in the second iodine solution. The entire plant goes in. And while that's immersing, we can prepare the second plant. As you can see, I bought this tissue culture about a week ago, but I caught a flu. So I did not treat it and I did not deflask it as early as I would like to. And you can tell that the jelly has a cloudy appearance. That's a sign that it might have been infected. So let us try our best to clean this up and hopefully the plant is still going to survive. I'm going to clean my hands so that I don't cross-contaminate the other guy. So while the plant is soaking, I'm going to add some substrate into the grow lid pot. Cleaning my hands again, it's very important to keep this process as clean as possible. I'm just adding a little bit of alcohol into the substrate. It's not possible to get it fully sterile in the substrate, but we want it to be as clean as possible. Okay, now that is done, we're going to take the first plant that we immersed and we are putting it into the substrate. Okay. And I'm just going to water it a little with the iodine water. This might seem excessively cautious, but I think it might help given the conditions that these plants were received in. So I'm going to just put the grow lid on top of it as a humidity dome. Okay, now that's one done. We are going to treat this plant next. So I want to be extra thorough with this particular plant because the substrate, the jelly substrate looks like it was infected. So I really want to get in there and rub off every bit of the jelly on the roots. You might damage the roots while doing this, but honestly, it's not going to matter as much as you think because the roots that are grown in tissue culture typically die off anyway. Because they can't really acclimatize to the conditions outside of tissue culture. But they're always good to keep on because it's going to just help the plant acclimatize while it's throwing out its new roots. Okay, now the roots are no longer slimy. I'm going to immerse the whole plant for a few minutes. Okay, I think we've given it the best chance to survive. We are going to put this inside the grow lid pot as well. And once again, with the grow lid as a humidity dome. We are in Singapore over here, so humidity is naturally quite high. If you are in a drier climate, you might want to have something to cover the larger holes as well. And this is how we deflask our tissue culture plants. So once this is hardened off in about 2 to 3 weeks time, we will be putting it on top of the grow lid with a grow pole where it will grow hydroponically and hopefully grow big very fast. In a few weeks time, we'll be migrating the tissue culture plants into the grow lid. So what's the grow lid? It's a hydroponic way to grow climbing aroids on our grow pole system. And you can tell from the condensation that the moss pole is incredibly well hydrated and well aerated at the same time, which really attracts the roots of climbing aroids to go inside, then take root and allow it to actually grow its large leaves in a mature form like what we have.